beautiful space and we're enjoying it so much. I totally enjoyed the setup with Ulma and talking with her, so thank you for the space, Gary.
Of course.
Now, the real reason we're here tonight is to celebrate Ulma and the book that she has helped bring to fruition. So I'd like to turn the
tables over to Ulma. So before I start, I just wanted to give a big thanks to everybody who's here. I know you had to reschedule whatever you had to and make time for me, and I appreciate every bit of it. So I'm a little bit of an emotional person, so if I cry, you have to bear with it. You don't have a choice. Basically,
that's the worst thing
about. That is
it all. So the launch of this book, I thought my mom would see it. And she didn't. She passed away on July 27th. But here's the funny thing about it. The day she passed away is the day the Indigo Book campaign launched. And there are people in this room that have done so much above and beyond what I could have expected, what I would have done for anybody else. And those people are very close to my heart, not that none of you others are not, but they pulled through a time that I didn't know what to do. I think I would just literally push the launch date to like maybe October, November, because it was just a month before the launch. And it was really a difficult choice to make. So first of all, I want to thank Pam. Pam, Madhavi, and three other friends, we all got together for almost a year, reviewed every single chapter in this book. All the meetings happened at Pam's house. There was plenty of food, and we were always like able to discuss and review, and if there were any edits that were needed, we did it. And that was really profound. So this is just the culmination of what happened between all these women who came together and made it possible. And you know, I actually, if you read my afterword, I have mentioned it there. If I had a community like this, I would definitely write a book every month. And I think we should do it if you have a community like that. Because without them, this would have been completely impossible. And next, I want to thank Jesse. So when I was out, literally not knowing what to do, what to post, every single email, every single social media post that you saw didn't come from me. Although it seemed very personal coming from me, it did not come from me. It was done by Jesse, and you know that really helped me to be at peace with whatever we're doing. So a couple of days before my mom passed away, I called both of these guys and said, hey, let's postpone it. And both of them said, no, we're not. We're going to forge forward. And I was like, that kind of support, not every human being can get. And I'm very, very thankful for every little contribution that has come the way. That doesn't mean I've forgotten the others. There are people who read the book, and they took time to read the book because it's not an easy read. You have to sit, you have to process, you have to think. There's so many things that happens with the book. And they all took their time in their day, and they all read the book. And they came back to me with rave reviews. And you know, as an author and a writer, it's not easy to write a book, and like you're kind of like doing this thinking like, hopefully everybody likes it. And that kind of fear was taken out of me by people who read the book and gave me the feedback and said, this is brilliant. Now, having said it's brilliant, I can't take the credit for everything. I don't know how many of you know, I didn't write the book. I did, and I didn't. I didn't because I didn't plan on this book. None of this was planned. I didn't plan on becoming an author. Even though I'm very good at talking, I'm a very shy person. I can come and talk to you, but I don't like being in public. I don't like being the center of attention. And this book is forcing me to do it. And I'm petrified. It's the truth. I don't want to be the public eye. However, this has happened. That means I've been pushed into something bigger than what I normally am comfortable with. So I'm stepping into something that's very uncomfortable for me. So therefore, I'm thanking every one of you for making my uncomfortableness disappear and being here and talking to all of you and really being grateful for it. Now, today is the book launch. There's one more favor I need from all of you, which is we need 20 five-star reviews for the book to make it to number one status. And I've sent emails, and there's several people that have started stepping in and doing it on for me. So I would appreciate appreciate it if others could step in and do the same favor. You don't need to read the whole book. I thought you had to. My publisher kind of tapped on my shoulder and said, it's not necessary. So that gives me a little bit room to say, hey, can you read a chapter for me and just give a review? So today, the book is available for purchase, if you haven't ordered already, online. And also, where was I going with this? Okay, so, you know, if you want a chapter, I can send one single chapter to you guys just to read it if you want. You don't want to purchase the book. But beyond anything, the book has a cause. So I'll keep it short, but basically the book was written to make money, but there's a bigger thing behind it rather than just making money. I would love to own an island and be there. That's not, you know, but that's not the reason we're launching this book. The reason we're launching this book is, one, as a community, as a society, as human beings, we have devolved rather than evolving, even though we think we've all evolved. We have really caused so much to the plant and the animal kingdom. So we are going to be having a nonprofit called Positively Yours, where once I'm paid the salary, every bit of money will go into wildlife preservation. So when you buy the book, there's a cause attached to it. Therefore, not for me, for the animals that are dying every single day.